Kukulipis, time for June favorites. And thankfully, June was a much better month than May in terms of positive things, exciting things, and upbeat things happening. So thank you all for your well wishes and for your love. It definitely carried me through the month of June. So I've got a couple products in front of me that I want to share with you for the month of June. I did want to float an idea by you first though, so you guys let me know down in that comment section what you think. Every time I sit down to film a June favorites, I usually try to, throughout the month, keep a list on my phone of what are the things that I've been loving. But I do find that I sort of lag halfway through the month and forget to actually write everything down. So I was wondering whether you guys would rather see weekly favorites or monthly favorites. I probably wouldn't film both, I just think it might be overkill. But I was sort of thinking that if I had weekly favorites, it would be easier to like keep a running tally of everything I used that week. Let me know what you think. I'll still do like July favorites, but maybe moving on in like August and after that, we might try the whole weekly favorites. Let me know what you guys think of that idea. But let us just get started, shall we? We've got a mishmash of products here. Not a huge amount, but yeah. I'll just jump right into it. So the first thing right here in front of me, because I reapplied it before I sat down, is this MAC lipstick in Please Me. It was one of the lipsticks that my sister bought me in my Nicole box. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I will link the video where I talk about all that sweetness down below. But it's just this color right here. It's a really pretty like blue toned pink. I just really like it. I have Nice and Spicy liner underneath it, which is a brownish color. That's why it's looking a little bit brown, but I love it as like an easy handbag type of lipstick. I just find it to be really pretty, and it is part of their permanent collection, so you gotta love that. This is the second lipstick, and it's a favorite and a little bit of a sadness at the same time. I have really been searching high and low for like a mauvey nude lipstick. I really want like a mauvey nude color. And no one quite seems to have the color I'm looking for. And if you know, please, please tell me. I still have to try the Beurre lip liner from MAC. Rada recommended that one. I'll link Rada's channel down below, but she recommended that one to me, so I still have to try that one. But I do want like a lipstick. And so this is the closest thing I found, and it's by Jo Fresh, which is the line from Superstore. And if you're not from Canada, then you have no idea what I'm talking about. But they have lipsticks, obviously. And this one is in Mocha, and it's a beautiful color, and it's the perfect color, and it's matte. And I'm trying to do a really gentle swatch. It's that color, the second color down there. It's the perfect color, but it broke. Like, I don't know if you can see that. I don't want it to fall everywhere and make a giant mess. But it broke. Like, this thing, if I were to tip it upside down, would fall off. And I've tried to sort of melt it in the microwave for like 10 seconds, stick it back on and throw it in the freezer. But it's still not holding together. So I did want to hang on to it just so I could show you guys. But unfortunately, I think it's going to have to go in the trash. It was only $6, so it's not a huge bummer. But it was the perfect color after a long search. So, yeah. I'm hoping I got like a bad tube, but I have really been loving that color. Let's move on to face. So this is my beautiful NARS Hot Sand Illuminator. I think I told you in another video that I was resisting the urge to buy a backup. Yeah, I think I'm done resisting that urge. I just found one. Like, I called my local department store and they have another one of this one. So I think I'm on my way to go pick it up because it's just beautiful. I have it mixed in with my foundation today. And I just feel like it gives me the most beautiful glow. And I like foundations with pink undertones. We've talked about this. But I like that this has a peach undertone because it gives me that glowy bronzy look that really complements the peach. I feel like a lot of the time with like those champagne-y colored like highlighters or illuminators, it gets too much like glittery sparkle on my face. And then the ones that are pink tone, they just really don't do anything because my foundations are so pink tone. With this one, I feel like it's bronzy without being too dark. So I really love it. If you are still able to get your hands on it, I highly recommend it because it's gorgeous. And what was I gonna say? And if not, Revlon has one that's sort of similar. I swatched it today. I was gonna buy it to sort of show you a comparison. It's the same color as this one, but this one has like a luminosity to it. I'm gonna try to bring it up closer to show you. Do you guys see how it has like sort of this like gold yellow veining that runs through it? That kind of detail or complexity is not in the Revlon one. But if you don't want to spend NARS kind of price, or if NARS is sold out, you could try the Revlon one for a similar effect. But I really have been adoring this guy. Hand in hand, this is another illuminator. This is High Beam by Benefit. I have it on in the way that I've been loving to use it, which is as a brow bone highlight. So it's just a pink base. I could probably do a swatch of this guy because you might not be able to see it on my eyes. But it's just a pink based highlighter, and I don't really adore it on my cheekbones. I just find that it doesn't blend the way I wish it would, but it's that right there. And so what I do is it has this little applicator that's like sort of like a nail polish type applicator like this. And I'll just put two dots on each side and then blend them in. So I'll either use my finger or like a small, what have I been using? If you have a really small sort of detailer brush, but I also find that with like, hold on, I'm all over the place today. Where are you, brush? So I'll either use something like a 231 from MAC because it's a little and it gets right in there, but I find that it's not quite the right consistency to blend it. So sometimes I'll spend a decent amount of time blending it out. So what I have been trying these last couple days and really loving, this is the Dome Shadow Brush from Real Techniques. So it's nice and fluffy. And I find that with that, it just like, let's see if I can show you. Probably not because it's set. But it just like blends it out really pretty. You guys see that? Probably not. But it blends it out really nice. And so Jackie, if you're watching, I know that you've been having trouble using this product. So try it out with like a fluffy brush as a brow bone highlight. I find it to be really super pretty. And that is a permanent item in the Benefit line. So you should have no trouble getting it. This next thing that I want to talk about is the Blend a Hand by The Balm. It's a blending brush. I don't know if this is what it's intended for because it says, un teint qui va mieux. Okay, that's in French. It's not helping. Why is it in French? It says blend a hand, un teint vaut mieux que deux. The translation for the French name is ridiculous. It has nothing to do with anything. But I've really been loving it, as you can see it's dirty, to blend out my under eye concealer. Nothing has ever blended out my under eye concealer like this one. I know Sigma makes a brush that's this sort of tapered form. That's almost like a duo fiber that people rave about. And so if you haven't been able to get your hands on that one and the Balm is more accessible to you, or you watch Hotlook has the Balm, hotlook.com I think, has the Balm on sale for 50% off a lot of the time. So if you watch out for that sale, I would highly, highly recommend this guy because it just blends out that concealer so it's not cakey, so it doesn't crease all day. It's just the most beautiful, beautiful finish. And it's super soft. I've washed it. It doesn't shed. I highly, highly recommend this guy to anyone really, because it's an awesome, awesome little brush and sort of a dupe for that Sigma one, I think. Oh, I've been talking fast today. The next thing that I've been loving is this Divergent limited edition multi-piece collector's palette. I almost wasn't going to show this because it is limited edition, but I did want to rave about it, and it is something I've been loving all month. Well, I haven't had it all month, but I've worn it enough as though I've had it all month. This was one of the things that my sweet friend Jasmine gave me in our swap. I will link Jasmine's beautiful channel down below. But I have been loving this constantly. Like, I wore it all last week. And so this is the palette itself. I hope we don't blind you with that mirror. So it has blush and a bronzer, which are on my face today. And even though this one looks really yellow, I don't find it to be super yellow. And then this is a very beautiful eye look. So you can do like all over color, crease color, or I usually do this, like, yeah, crease color. And then like outer V or like lower lash line, or even a liner with this guy is great. So, yeah, I have been loving this guy, wearing it like crazy. I'm gonna show you how that bronzer, see this guy, it looks pretty yellow, but do you see it on my finger right there? And then on my hand right here. So it does have that yellowish tone to it that I'm not usually a huge fan of, but I just find that, so it's what I'm wearing as a contour today, and the blush is what I'm wearing as a blush today. I just find that it makes a very beautiful face, like you can do your whole face with it. And it's, they're beautiful, beautiful, super creamy, super pigmented, easy to work with shadows. And I've just really been loving it. I think it also does have definitely a very special place in my heart. We're gonna wipe up these swatches because I've already got some on my shirt. It has a special place in my heart because of Jasmine, and so I love it even more for that. But I just thought I'd mention it in case any of you had it and, you know, wanted to remember to pull it out, because it's a gorgeous, gorgeous little palette there. What else do I want to talk about? I am all over the place today for no good reason. I have two perfumes that I want to talk about, and I've been wearing them together, so I thought I'd mention them. This one I mentioned in a mall haul I did recently. It's the Victoria's Secret's Very Sexy Now perfume, which is a bit like a muskier scent. It's not super musky. Like, it's like a musky sweet scent. It's like if you walked into Victoria's Secret's and it was a day where there were a lot of like boyfriends in there with the girls. Yeah, that's what it sort of smells like. It's like got all the fruitiness of like that very Victoria's Secret smell, but like a little bit of muskiness in there, which I love musky scents, so I've been loving this. And then I will sometimes spritz on top of that to just give it a little bit more depth, is this Hermès Pamplemousse Rose, I think, Concentré de Pamplemousse Rose, pink grapefruit perfume from Hermès. And it's just, it's a super, it's what it says. It literally smells not smoked, like juiced grapefruits all in here. I do owe you guys an updated perfume collection, and I will film that soon, I promise. I just have been, filming other things, waiting for some stuff to come in. Anyways, I will film that. But this combo I've really been loving. This one was limited edition. I think last time I saw it, last week, I want to say, it was still on the Victoria's Secret's website. But if I will, I've been trying to start linking everything I talk about in MT's videos and haul videos and favorite videos. I've been trying to link not only the name, but the link to the website itself. So I will link both full names and whatever I can find websites to, I will. This one is permanent, so I should be able to find one. But I will link all that kind of good stuff down in that description box. Okay. I don't know what is happening with us today, but we are in a bit of a strange mood and losing our breath for no good reason. But I think we'll leave you at that. Is there anything else I want to tell you? Oh, yes, there is. I don't know what look I want to film for Thursday. And so I could use your inspiration. What I'm thinking about currently and what I will end up doing probably if I just decide to sit down and film, or you guys don't have anything you necessarily specifically want to see, I sort of want to do a whole look based around these violet lips. So I'd probably wear like my fuchsia hijabista veil and do like a pop of pink on the eyes and then these lips. But and I might film that look anyways. But let me know if there's a specific look you'd like to see on Thursday. I try to film tutorials for Thursday. So let me know if there's anything in particular you guys want to see for this week. I think that's it now. Oh, I'm all over the place today. I was gonna give you, as always, my favorite book for the month of June. So I have been loving, I haven't quite finished it yet, but it's so good that I had to mention it, Anna and the French Kiss, which I've heard is one of my friend Lydia's great books, and it was actually a book recommended to me by her lovely friend Anka. Anka and Lydia have a beautiful channel where they do book reviews, book hauls, book tags, everything book related that you could ever want. And they are amazing ladies. I will link their channel down below. But Anka recommended the book to me, and thank you very much. It is awesome. I'm not quite through with it yet, but I know I had to mention it in today's video. Oh God, I am so out of breath. I think now that's everything. Yeah, let's do 3 points of positivity. Three things about June that were awesome. The first has definitely got to be that I have my little sister back, and I swear to you just wholeheartedly that girl is a piece of my soul. Like, the minute she landed, we literally just went out for dinner and then went out for ice cream and then went out for a walk, and it was like 4 or 5 hours of nonstop talking, and I just like felt this overwhelming sense of peace and love, and like a part of me that was missing was bad. Like, I just felt so at ease and so happy. Anyone who has amazing siblings, again, by birth or by fate, knows what that feeling is like when you're reunited and you just feel whole again. That was the feeling I got to experience this month, which has been fantastic. Second, hand in hand with that, so I am filming this on Saturday, and Ramadan starts for us on Sunday. So today is the last day I could like have lunch in the daytime. And so we went to the Olive Garden, and it was so yummy. And I ate way too much. Maybe that's why I'm in a weird mood. I've had a lot of carbs. And I don't know how my body's dealing with like that carb overload. But it was an awesome lunch, and we just had a lot of fun. And my third point of positivity is this makeup, which my little sister is telling me looks like a butterfly, which I'm going to take as a compliment. But I got, I don't know if you guys can see, if it's picking up on camera, it should. I tried to do this like little pop of color right in here. It was inspired by Samantha from Battle Lash Beauty. If you have not checked out that amazing channel, I will link it down below. But she is an incredible genius of a makeup artist and a fellow Canadian. But she was doing, I think like What's in My Travel Makeup Bag or something, and she had a look that had like a pop of color in here. It was like a turquoise color. It was so beautiful. So this started out as a neutral eye today and then just went crazy. So this actual makeup look, I know it's not like specific to June, but I feel like in June I played with a lot of colors, this look being endemic of it. See my little tie-in? So that has definitely been something that has been making me smile. As always, please, please, please share with me what is bringing you joy and happiness and sunshine down in that description box or comment section. Yeah, that's the right word. I want to send you guys tons of love. Hope your June was fantastic, full of sunshine. And if it wasn't, I want to send you tons of love and strength and let you know that I'm thinking of you. And yeah, I hope it'll be better soon. And tons of love, happiness, sunshine. Thank you for being here so much. I really appreciate it. And as always, I can never leave you without reminding you to stay awesome and that life is just too short to wear boring lipstick. Bye, guys.